It's hard to imagine, but all of this vast expanse was once lake bottom. This was all part of ancient Lake Bonneville. And the fish that once lived here have now been concentrated to a few little small marshes and bogs. Aquatic biologist Paul Thompson explained some of the efforts that are being made to preserve these fish from becoming extinct.
So primarily what I do is I work on native aquatic species in northern Utah, which are primarily fish. Today, we're looking at least chub, which is endemic to Utah, which means it's the only place in the world it occurs is within the state of Utah. Least chub evolved in Lake Bonneville, and as Lake Bonneville drained, they became, they took up residency in springs and marshes and streams that were left within the Bonneville Basin. Today in Utah, we have 6 known populations of least chub that are still left in the wild. Some of these populations aren't doing as well as others. Some of the factors why they're not doing as well would be introduced fishes, large fish like bass and carp, and even small fish like shiners and killifish. They don't compete well with non-native fish, and also being a small minnow or small chub, maximum length about 2 inches, they can be eaten as prey as well. Of these 6 populations, we are moving them into 25. New locations that typically are fishless because they do well just as the only species present. And one of those is this pond here on Antelope Island. It's a backup to one of our wild populations. Now, least chub being a small fish, maybe get up to 2 inches in length, you might wonder why we care. One of the main reasons we're doing this is to keep this species intact and not from going extinct. But also as a state, we want to keep these fish off the Endangered Species Act. We don't want them to be listed as threatened or endangered federally, because that means they've already gotten to the point that their populations are so low, most of those species cannot come back from that. So we want to be proactive and do the work with these species now, like least chub, to keep them from being listed federally.
Now, these are little fish, but the efforts that are being made are big. In behalf of everyone who loves Utah's fish and wildlife and wants to save a place for them, I'm Phil Douglas from the Utah Division of Wildlife Resources Northern Region.